Good evening. I'm Reverend Dr. Martha Jacobs. I welcome you to our Maundy Thursday service. If you would like to follow along, you can go to our website and download the order of service. Just go to fcc-chappaqua.org. Well, this year, my friends, instead of our having gathered for the upper room meal first, we have to use our imaginations as we remember the final meal that Jesus had with his disciples and his friends. They had gathered around the table, and Jesus had blessed the bread and the wine and shared it with them. There was teaching, of course, which Jesus always did, and he tried to instill in them the importance of loving and caring for each other, and reminding them of the radical inclusiveness that he had demonstrated during his 3 years with them. Jesus knew that this would be his final opportunity to help them understand what God had sent him to do, so that they would continue his important work on earth. This evening, we will read the stories from the various Gospels that tell the final hours of the earthly life of Jesus. At the end of the service, the carillon will ring 33 times to signify the 33 years that Jesus was with us. And while that is happening, I will be stripping the altar and preparing it for Good Friday and Holy Saturday. I invite you to join us tomorrow evening at 7 o'clock for a meditative service of readings, prayers, and music. And then, of course, I invite you to celebrate with us at 10 a.m. on Easter Sunday, when we will celebrate the rebirth of God's love for us through prayers, music, a sermon, and communion. And so, my friends, let us take a moment to pause, and then we will begin. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was in the beginning with God. All things came into being through him, and without him, not one thing came into being. What has come into being in him was life, and the life was the light of all people. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness did not overcome it. When it was evening, he took his place with the 12, and while they were eating, he said, "Truly I tell you, one of you will betray me." And they became greatly distressed and began to say to him one after another, "Surely not I, Lord, surely not I." He answered, "The one who has dipped his hand into the bowl with me will betray me. The Son of Man goes as it is written of him. But woe to that one by whom the Son of Man is betrayed. It would have been better for that one not to have been born." Judas, who betrayed him, said, "Surely not I, Rabbi." Jesus replied, "You have said so." When they had sung the hymn, they went out to the Mount of Olives. Then Jesus said to them, "You will all become deserters because of me this night. For it is written, I will strike the shepherd, and the sheep of the flock will be scattered. But after I am raised up, I will go ahead of you to Galilee." Peter said to him, "Though all become deserters because of you, I will never desert you." Jesus said to him, "Truly I tell you, this very night, before the cock crows, you will deny me 3 times. Peter said to him, "Even though I must die with you, I will not deny you." And so said all of the disciples. Then Jesus went with them to a place called Gethsemane, and he said to his disciples, "Sit here while I go over there and pray." He took with him Peter and the 2 sons of Zebedee and began to be grieved and agitated. Then he said to them, "I am deeply grieved, even to death. Remain here, and stay awake with me." And going a little farther, he threw himself on the ground and prayed, "My Father, if it is possible, let this cup pass from me. Yet, not what I want, but what you want." Then he came to the disciples, and he found them sleeping. He said to Peter, "So could you not stay awake with me 1 hour? Stay awake and pray that you may not come into the time of trial. The spirit indeed is willing, but the flesh is weak." Again, he went away for the second time and prayed, "My Father, if this cannot pass unless I drink it, your will be done." Immediately, while he was still speaking, Judas, one of the 12, arrived. And with him there was a crowd with swords and clubs from the chief priests, the scribes, and the elders. Now the betrayer had given them a sign, saying, "The one I will kiss is the man. Arrest him and lead him away under guard." So when he came, he went up to him at once and said, "Rabbi," and kissed him. Then they laid hands on him and arrested him. Suddenly, one of those with Jesus put his hand on his sword and drew it and struck the slave of the high priest, cutting off his ear. Then Jesus said to him, "Put your sword back into its place, for all who take the sword will perish by the sword. Do you think I cannot appeal to my Father, and he will at once send me more than 12 legions of angels? But how then would the scriptures be fulfilled, which say it must happen in this way?" At that hour, Jesus said to the crowds, "Have you come out with swords and clubs to arrest me, as though I were a bandit? Day after day I sat in the temple teaching, and you did not arrest me. But all this has taken place so that the scriptures of the prophets may be fulfilled." Then all the disciples deserted him and fled. Now Peter was sitting outside in the courtyard. A servant girl came to him and said, "You also were with Jesus the Galilean." But he denied it before all of them, saying, "I do not know what you are talking about." When he went out to the porch, another servant girl saw them, and she said to the bystanders, This man was with Jesus of Nazareth." Again, he denied it with an oath, "I do not know the man." After a little while, the bystanders came up and said to Peter, Certainly, you are also one of them, for your accent betrays you." Then he began to curse, and he swore an oath, "I do not know that man." At that moment, the cock crowed. Then Peter remembered what Jesus had said, "Before the cock crows, you will deny me 3 times. And he went out and wept bitterly. Then Pilate entered the headquarters again, summoned Jesus, and asked him, "Are you the king of the Jews?" Jesus answered, "Do you ask me this on your own, or did others tell you about me?" Pilate replied, "I am not a Jew, am I? Your own nation and the chief priests have handed you over to me. What have you done?" Jesus answered, "My kingdom is not from this world. If my kingdom were from this world, my followers would be fighting to keep me from being handed over to the Jews. But as it is, my kingdom is not from here." Pilate asked him, "So you are a king?" Jesus answered, "You said that I am a king. For this I was born, and for this I came into the world, to testify to the truth. Everyone who belongs to the truth listens to my voice." Pilate asked him, "What is truth?" After he said this, he went out to the Jews again and told them, "I find no case against him." Then the soldiers led him into the courtyard of the palace, that is, the governor's headquarters. And they called together the whole cohort, and they clothed him in a purple cloak. And after twisting some thorns into a crown, they put it on him, and they began saluting him, "Hail, hail, King of the Jews!" They struck his head with a reed and spat upon him, and knelt down in homage to him. After mocking him, they stripped him of the purple cloak and put his own clothes on him. Then they led him out to crucify him. He was in the world, and the world came into being through him. Yet, the world did not know him. He came to what was his own, and his own people did not accept him. But to all who received him, who believed in his name, he gave power to become children of God, who were born not of blood or of the will of the flesh or of the will of man, but of